गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फॉर क्लास 10th एंड टुडेज टॉपिक आई हैव चूजन इज ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। सो बेसिक इन्फॉर्मेशन वी ऑल हैव अबाउट ट्रिग्नोमेट्री, बट बिफोर आई स्टार्ट द चैप्टर और द एक्सरसाइजेस फ्रॉम आवर क्लास 10th बुक, आई विल रिवाइज सम ऑफ द टॉपिक्स और सम ऑफ द थिंग्स अबाउट ट्रिग्नोमेट्री विच वी हैव डन अर्लियर। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट ट्रिग्नोमेट्री, वी नीड टू नो about the right angle triangle. What is a right angle triangle? A triangle in which one angle is of 90 degree is called a right angle triangle. If this triangle ABC is a right angle triangle, then in front of this 90 degree we will have the hypotenuse and this will be the base and one side will be the perpendicular. This side or this side, they may be one of them will be perpendicular or base, or this can be base or this can be perpendicular, but the place of hypotenuse is fixed. In front of 90 degree angle, the side will always be the hypotenuse for the triangle. Now if we have any right angle triangle, then we need to know a theorem, Pythagoras theorem. I hope you all know about it. What is Pythagoras theorem? Pythagoras theorem is, in any right angle triangle, the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of squares of other two sides. That is, hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. So if hypotenuse is AC, so we can write AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Or with the help of this theorem or this formula, like I have written hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square, you can also write perpendicular square is equal to hypotenuse square minus base square. Or if you want, or if you want to get base square or base, you can write hypotenuse square minus perpendicular square. So these three we will use directly in trigonometry. So about the basic information of trigonometry, trigonometry is all about triangles. Like in the name of trigonometry, the tri is coming in the beginning. Tri means three. Three means a figure in which three sides are there or in which three angles are there. So that kind of figure is what? Triangles. Now, in class 9, we all have studied about trigonometrical ratios. So if we have any right angle triangle, and if I write here A, B and C, and this is 90 degree, as I have told you, wherever the 90 degree angle will be there, the hypotenuse will be in front of the 90 degree, one side will be perpendicular and one will be base. Okay. Now, if we talk about trigonometrical ratios, we all know about sine, cos and tan. They are the three main trigonometrical ratios. We used to write sine theta, cos theta and tan theta, because trigonometrical ratios will be with the angles. Now, what is the value of sine theta? We all know sine theta is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse, and cos theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse, and yes, tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base. We all have done in class 9. So sine theta is the first trigonometrical ratio. This is nothing but the ratio of perpendicular and hypotenuse in any right angle triangle. In second, cos theta is base upon hypotenuse. And the third one is tan theta, which is perpendicular upon base. But we need to know about the opposites of these three also. Like tan theta, the opposite of tan theta is cot theta. Opposite of cos is sec theta. And opposite of sine will be cosec theta. So if cot is the opposite of tan, then if tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base, we can write base upon perpendicular for cot. In the same way, sec is the opposite of cos, so we can write hypotenuse upon base as the formula for sec. And now cosec, the opposite of sine, so hypotenuse upon perpendicular will be the formula or the ratio of hypotenuse of perpendicular for what? Cosec theta. Now if we have sine cos tan and cot sec cosec, sine theta perpendicular upon hypotenuse, cos theta base upon hypotenuse, and tan theta perpendicular upon base. So, for the shortcut, we need to write perpendicular upon hypotenuse, base upon hypotenuse, and perpendicular upon base. The first one is for sine, second one is for cos, third one is for tan. Sine, cos, tan. So, PBP upon HHB, we to remember it easily, students only have made Pandit Badri Prasad Har Har Bole. It's just like fun. Pandit Badri Prasad Har Har Bole to remember about this formula. Okay. P upon H is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. B upon H is base upon hypotenuse. And P upon B is perpendicular upon base. Okay. Now, if trigonometrical ratios we know, and I told you what is the opposite of which trigonometrical ratio, like sin theta, we can write 1 upon cosec theta. I told you the opposite of sin is cosec, so we can write sin theta into cosec theta is equal to 1, first one. Now, second one, cos theta we can write 1 upon sec theta, so in the same way, cos theta into sec theta is equal to 1. And the third one will be, as tan theta is equal to 1 upon cot theta, we can write, because tan is opposite of cot and cot is opposite of tan. So tan theta into cot theta is equal to 1. These three formulas also we will use directly wherever required. One more thing, sin theta upon cos theta will always be what? Tan theta. This is the formula. So if something or somewhere required in place of cot theta, if sin theta upon cos theta is tan theta, so cot theta will be cos theta upon sin theta. These formulas we will use directly for the questions. Now, this is all about basics, which we have already done, but just to recall, okay, now, we all have done sine, cos and tan, 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree value for these trigonometrical ratios. So, once again we will revise it, because if we are studying about trigonometry, we need to know about the angles of the trigonometrical ratios. Now, the value of sine 0 degree is 0, for 30 degree it is 1 by 2, 45 degree root 3 by 2, sorry, 45 degree 1 by under root 2, sin 60 root 3 by 2, sin 90 will be 1. This 1 we will write here and we will get the value of cos 0 degree. This root 3 by 2 we will write here, we will get the value of cos 30 degree. For cos 45 the same, for the sin 45 and cos 45 values are same. This 1 by 2 will come this side and this 0 will come here. This is the easy way to remember the values of sine, cos and tan. Sorry, sine and cos. Now, tan theta, I have told you, is sine upon cos. The ratio of sine and cos. So, 0 upon 1 means what? 0. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2, we will get 1 by root 3. 1 by root 2 upon 1 by root 2 means 1. This will be root 3 and this will be not defined. So, they are the values of sine 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 degree, and cos 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree and so on. In the same way, we can find the values of sec, cot and cosec also, just to reverse it. Now, if we have the values of sin 0, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree, and then complementary angles also we have done. What are they? Complementary angles means, if sum of two angles is 90 degree, then they are called what? Complementary angles. So, we have done about sine 90 minus theta, cos 90 minus theta, tan 90 minus theta. Then the opposite of these, cot 90 minus theta, sec 90 minus theta, and cosec 90 minus theta. This is a very important part. Please remember it. Please learn it. Now, sin 90 minus theta will be cos theta. Cos 90 minus theta will be sin theta. Tan will be cot. Cot will be the tan theta. Sec theta means cosec theta. Sec 90 minus theta means cosec theta. And cosec 90 minus theta will be sec theta. These things we will use directly. But after this 90 minus theta, now let us see. We use sin 90 plus theta. Cos 90 plus theta. Tan 90 plus theta. So what we will write here. Now, please remember that sin 90 plus theta means cos theta. Cos 90 plus theta will be sin theta but in negative. Tan 90 plus theta will be cot theta. This also will be negative. Then, opposite of these, cot 90 plus theta will be tan theta, but it will be negative. Sec 90 plus theta will be cosec theta. This also will be negative. And cosec 90 plus theta will be sec theta, but this will be in positive. So, for 90 plus theta, remember that. In case of 90 plus theta, only sin and cosec will be in positive, but remaining all the terms will be in negative. Please remember that. Okay? Sin and cosec will be positive, but remaining cos, tan, cot, and sec will be negative. Remember that. We will take the example of that. Like, if we get sin 90 minus 30, so we will write cos 30 degree, and the value of cos 30 is what? Cos 30 means root 3 by 2. This was for what? Complementary angles. And if we get sin 90 plus 30 degree, 90 plus 30 means what? Sin 120 degree. So in place of 120, we can write 90 plus 30. And sin 90 plus 30, let us see what is the formula here. Sin 90 plus 30 means cos theta. So cos 30 degree. But in positive or negative, because it is a matter of sin, so it will be positive. I told you 90 plus theta means plus something plus in 90 degree. 90 plus something means it goes in the second quadrant. First quadrant is 0 to 90 degree. As we can see here, this is first quadrant and this is from 0 to 90. This is second quadrant, 90 to 180. In second quadrant, sin and cosec will be positive and remaining all the trigonometrical ratios will be in negative. So, if you have to find the value of sin 120 degree, so what we will write? Sin 90 plus 30 and sin 90 plus theta, the formula is cos theta but in positive. So, we will write cos 30 degree and the value of cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Let us take some more examples. Just like that, if you have to find the value of sin 150 degree, what we can do? Let us see. We can write sin 90 plus 60 degree. Can we write? Yes. 90 plus 60 means 150. So sin 90 plus theta means cos theta, as we have written here, the formula. So sin 90 plus theta cos theta. Cos 60 degree, but in positive or negative? Yes, it will be in positive because in second quadrant, sin is positive. So cos 60 is nothing but the value is 1 by 2. You need to remember that. So this is the way you will find the values of if they are more than 90 degree. With the help of these two, in other classes you will study about 180 plus theta and 180 minus theta also, 270 plus theta and 270 minus theta also. But for now, in your course, only this much is there. This much I have told you, some extra. Now, trigonometrical identities you must have done. Three trigonometrical identities mainly you have done. What are they? Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. एंड कोसेक स्क्वायर थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1 प्लस कॉट स्क्वायर थीटा. फर्स्ट सेकेंड एंड दिस थर्ड वन दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड वी विल यूज इट डायरेक्टली इन द क्वेश्चंस. बट व्हाट वी विल यूज सी इफ साइन स्क्वायर थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1 प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा सो दिस कैन बी रिटन एज साइन स्क्वायर थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा ऑल्सो और यू कैन राइट कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस साइन स्क्वायर थीटा. दिस मच वी कैन राइट. इन द सेम वे सेक स्क्वायर थीटा माइनस टेन स्क्वायर थीटा इज इक्वल टू 1 वी कैन राइट और वी कैन राइट सेक स्क्वायर थीटा माइनस 1 इज इक्वल टू टेन स्क्वायर थीटा जस्ट टू ट्रांसफॉर्म द ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिकल रेशियोज. ओके इन द सेम वे कोसेक स्क्वायर थीटा माइनस कॉट स्क्वायर थीटा विल बी 1 और इफ यू विश इफ यू आर रिक्वायर्ड यू कैन राइट कोसेक स्क्वायर थीटा माइनस 1 इज इक्वल टू कॉट स्क्वायर थीटा ऑल्सो वी विल यूज. Now let us see how they came, how these three formulas came. Let us check. I have already told you in a right angle triangle, this is hypotenuse, this is perpendicular and this is base. So let us see how these three formulas sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1, sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta and cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus cos square, 1 plus cot square theta came. See. In this triangle, right angle triangle, with the help of Pythagoras theorem, we all know hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. We all know that. So we will use now for the first one. Let us divide it by hypotenuse square. Divided by hypotenuse square. Now what we will get? Let us see. Hypotenuse is 1. P upon H whole square plus V upon H whole square. And this is nothing but P upon H is what? I have told you sine theta. So we can write sine square theta. And V upon H is what? Cos theta. So cos square theta we will write. So the first identity we have got. Again, if I write the same formula, hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square, and in the second step, like in the first one, we divided all the three terms by hypotenuse, it is divided by perpendicular. Perpendicular and perpendicular. What we will get? Let us see. H upon P whole square. P upon P means 1, and B upon P whole square. H upon P. Let us see. Perpendicular upon hypotenuse is what? Sine theta. But hypotenuse upon perpendicular will be cosec theta. So we will write cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus B upon P, that is base upon perpendicular. Perpendicular upon base is tan theta. So B upon P is cot theta. So we will write cot square theta. This is the second identity. In the same way, if the same formula is there, hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square, let us divide all the three terms by base square. This is nothing but just a proof how we got all these three formulas. Because they are very important, so we can write H upon B whole square, P upon B whole square plus 1. So H upon B, hypotenuse upon base is what? Base upon hypotenuse is cos theta. So hypotenuse upon base is what? Sec theta. So we can write sec square theta is equal to P upon B, perpendicular upon base, tan square theta plus 1. Sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. So they are the three formulas, and this is nothing but just a small derivation how these formulas came. Just to remember it, they are all from class 9th. But before we start this class 10th trigonometry, we need to recall all these. Okay, so now we have discussed about what is trigonometrical ratio, sine, cos, tan, cot, sec, cosec. The formula for tan is sine upon cos. All the values 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 degree basically for sine, cos, tan, cot, sec, cosec. And three identities of trigonometry, sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta and sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. and also we have done the complementary angles, sine 90 minus theta, cos 90 minus theta and tan 90 minus theta, and yes, we have done sine 90 plus theta also, cos 90 plus theta also and tan 90 plus theta also to find the angles greater than 90 degree. So this is all for today. In our next lecture, we will solve some more questions about trigonometry of class 10th level. Thank you so much. See you soon.